If you do not have the latest version of Microsoft 365, you won't have access to the XLookup function. And what we need to do sometimes is do what would be called the equivalent of a leftward VLookup. Using the VLookup function, you cannot look leftward in a list. But that's what we need to do based on the data we're seeing on this worksheet. There's a list over in columns A, B, and C. We can't change the order of it. It's used by functions and formulas in other workbooks and in other worksheets. So its order is static. But we've got a list over in column G, and we need to pull in the names based on the social security number. So the idea would be, if you were using VLookup, to say, let's look this up in a list and then move leftward to pick up the corresponding name. But we can't really do that. So sometimes we have to use the match and index functions together. And we start with the inner function, the match function first. Let's just see where this social security number is found, if it is found. We're trying to match up this social security number, comma, in which location? Over in column C, comma, and this needs to be an exact match. We put in 0, enter. It's found in the 10th row. You see it over there. The social security number that begins with 411-95. Now, armed with that information, we're now going to use the index function. The index function pulls data out of a range of cells. So let's double click here, and right after the equal sign, let's put in index, left parenthesis. The range that we're looking at, and we'll do this two different ways, is in columns A through C, comma. The row reference here was derived by the match function. Remember, that told us that it was in row 10. So that's our row reference. So following that, we put in a comma. Our column reference, reading from left to right, is 1, refers to column A. So in the range A through C, columns A through C, the 1, the column reference to the right, refers to column A. We need a right parenthesis here, enter, and there it is, Saul Goodman. We'll drag this down a few. If there is no match, we'll get a message. These all appear to be working properly. Kim Wexler there is also found over there in row 14. We see how that's working too, matching up with the social security number. Now, to make this a little bit simpler, I'll go back to the first one. At the time we're actually trying to pull data out of that list, we really are only looking in column A. So the index reference here need only refer to column A. And because we are looking only within a single column, we do need the row reference, of course, but we don't need that column reference at the end. So this can be simplified a bit. Take out the column reference, enter. That's looking good. Copy this down, getting the same answers. And ultimately, we'll copy this all the way down the column. And so we see it working there. So using these two together, in effect, what we're doing is the equivalent of what would be a leftward VLOOKUP.